So today I'm here to talk to you about what's kind of a rare species now, which is a plant called butternut, and its common relative, black walnut. So butternut is here on the right. This is what the actual nuts look like. So these are edible. These are edible nuts. However, there's not very many of them, although it depends on what part of the country you're in. Here in Missouri, they're really, really rare. This comes from a cultivated population, which is why I'm just showing you these individual nuts. I do have a bunch of them I'm going to try to grow. This is what they look like when they're still in the husk. Now, of course, these are not botanically true nuts. This is actually a drupe. So this husk, this is actually the flesh. So the endocarp, that's this stuff on the inside, and the seed is on the inside of this. So this is technically relate kind of like a stone fruit in a way. So it's not actually a true nut, but they're mostly called nuts. So if I call them nuts, that's basically the culinary term. But to identify them in the wintertime, you can use a twig. So if you see this twig right here, right on that little spot right there, there's a little mustache right above the leaf scar. And also the vascular bundles, those little dots on the inside of the leaf scar there, they're a little bit darker usually than they are in black walnut. The bud is usually longer and thinner. And the lenticels, if it's a pure butternut, will usually be little dots. Now I mentioned pure versus hybrid butternut because pure butternut is being attacked by a fungus that is killing it, which has a really horrible name, which I will put up for you. But unfortunately, it's pretty much being wiped out most places. It does hybridize with an Asian species, Juglans ailanthifolia, which basically means it looks like ailanthus, which is another non-native species, also called tree of heaven. But it hybridizes freely with it. And there's a lot of the butternuts that are around still are actually hybrids with it, and they're really hard to tell. As far as I know, this particular plant isn't a hybrid. I will show you a hybrid in a little bit. But the main thing you would probably confuse it with is this guy over here. So this is black walnut. So this is what the nuts look like. And that's the endocarp. So just like the butternut, it's got this kind of fleshy, but the flesh is really gross. This is green when it's fresh, but you can see here's the actual endocarp or nut is on the inside here. And unlike the butternut, this is smooth. So it's not fuzzy. So if you see the butternut over here, it's kind of long and football shaped and it's fuzzy. So if you're looking to tell the difference, that's one of the things you can use to tell the difference. So here's the twig. And it's often important to be able to tell these without leaves because both species tend to drop their leaves a little bit early in the fall, sometimes even before the nuts all fall off. So notice the bud is a lot shorter and blunter. A lot of times, although not all the time, it'll have this kind of whitish cast to it. It's probably from a little bit of trichomes. And if you can see the leaf scar, it's not super obvious. You don't get those light spots that you do on the butternut. So the other way to tell it is actually the bark. Now I'll have to switch a little bit and show you some slides that I have some pictures that I took. But mainly, they look pretty different. The twigs are typically more greenish. This species is really common pretty much all over the United States. No, not all over the United States, the eastern part of the United States. Butternut, it has a very similar range, but it's always been less common. Both of them will have this kind of ladder structure as their pith, and usually it's kind of dark chocolatey brown. And you can find these, at least black walnut, usually it's kind of in a more wetland area. These will go from wetlands, but they survive better, especially with the fungus, in more upland areas. They also grow much farther north. They can tolerate a lot colder temperatures. So where I've seen most of them is actually up in Canada. It's considered an endangered species there. The scientific name is Juglans cinerea, which basically means, in Latin, it means ashy because the bark is kind of grayish colored. I'll show you what the black walnut looks like. It's a super common species. They look very similar, but this one actually is not susceptible, at least it isn't damaged by the fungus. It may actually be, the fungus may grow on it, but it won't actually damage the tree in any meaningful fashion. These, they get these black cankers, and eventually the cankers kind of coalesce and it kills the tree. And they don't, unlike some of the other diseases out there, they don't really get to reproduce very well from seed. They don't come back from the roots, so it's really, really wiping them out. But I'll show you the hybrid in just a second. All right, so I mentioned the hybrid. This is what this is. So I've planted one of these. It's called, sometimes called Buartnut, because one of the forms of Juglans ailanthifolia is heartnut. So the hybrid is butternut plus heartnut equals Buartnut. Scientific term for this is Juglans bixbyi or bixby. So here I've got, this is true butternut next to this hybrid. So it's pretty similar. They both have kind of that little fuzzy mustache going on, but notice the bud's a little bit shorter, a little bit blockier. Here, but it does have kind of those dark leaf scars, but the leaf scar is a little less heart-shaped, and this one at least is really fuzzy, which true butternut does not seem to have. The lenticels also tend to be a little bit more drawn out rather than round. They're kind of pulled away, they're kind of long streaks. And some of that, I think, is from the tree itself. They tend to grow pretty fast. This one's actually in my little goat slash sheep pasture. And you can see that kind of grayish bark, which is similar to the butternut. But it's been a little bit difficult to get true butternut because there's actually a quarantine on Missouri because of the disease that's killing them. Unfortunately, there's hardly any native ones, so kind of like closing the barn door after the horses have gone. The hybrids seem to have at least some resistance. There's been no resistance detected in any of the original, just the plain species. Any that seem to be resistant all seem to be hybrids. So hopefully in the future we'll have butternuts again. Tell that they were grafted on black walnut. So this one, the graft, the understock, the black walnut understock has actually come up next to this butternut over here. So on the right, you can see here, on the right, you can see this butternut here. So notice it's got this really gray bark. Now, eventually it does get a little bit platy when the tree gets relatively large, but it's kind of this ash gray color. So again, that's the scientific name, Juglans cinerea. So this is this ashy gray color. So right here, we've got Juglans nigra. This is the black walnut. And usually when it's young, it kind of has this slightly brown, a little bit gray, but slightly brownish. And then as it gets older, it gets darker and darker and gets this nice kind of chocolate brown color. So also to show you, I've got some of the twigs. So this is under the dissecting scope. So this is this fuzzy mustache of trichomes that's just underneath the bud. This is actually a flower bud. This is the regular bud up here. And then you can see this is the leaf scar here. Then if we look here, you can actually see the vascular bundles are usually a little bit darker on butternut. This is versus black walnut. These vascular scars aren't as obvious. Also notice there's no mustache. You still got the two buds there. So don't really have much fuzz there. So this should hopefully be able to help you tell the difference between black walnut and butternut. This is important because butternuts are now rare. So if you happen to find especially a large butternut, but even small butternuts today, if you find one, you should definitely report it with tree snap, use iNaturalist, tell somebody about it, because we really need to preserve germplasm. The northern part of its range is not doing quite as badly, but it's still quite a rare species. So keep your eyes peeled for this one.
Watch for the butternuts, watch for these guys, and plant them if you can, because the more there are on the landscape, the more we're preserving germplasm. So I hope you like this kind of content. If you do, please like and subscribe, and I'll keep making more.